the ranger!
In the Great Hall of Minas Ithil, we didn't just safeguard the treasures of our past. We kept our present there as well. An archive of all our official correspondence with the capital. I used to file away missives from Minas Tirith after my father had read them. This was a weekly task at first, but as our surroundings grew more dangerous, scrolls like this one became more rare. I wonder whether there were promises of aid that the Orcs intercepted. Plans for relief that we never saw.
Workings of government reduced to parchment.
Minas Ithil didn't need parchment. It needed reinforcements.
Kill that cat and feel!
want something, it had better stay away!
Gondorian folktales abound with drakes, lesser versions of the great dragons who supposedly slumber under the earth. Yet here in Mordor, I've seen them with my own eyes, though from a safe distance, and they are nothing like the storybooks say. They are lethal hunters of the air, rapacious and cruel, apt to torment their prey before eating it. This scale, taken from a drake carcass we found in a ground cave, gives some sense of their size, and how strong they must be to carry such weight aloft.
Scale of a drake or full-fledged dragon?
Certainly a drake. Dragons take better care of their scales.
Always said, a proper warbanner has two roles, to direct and to inspire. In the chaos of battle, he'd say, "You won't march wrong if you keep your flag in sight." Now the orcs have cast down our banners, but Gondor's flag still inspires, even if I see it only in my mind's eye. So long as one Gondorian lives, the white tree still stands tall.
The flag of our people. Long may it fly.
Concern yourself more with the towers it's flying from.
My flesh grows dry, drained, and depleted, but their hunger does not abate! Now, I'll leave you to rot with the maggots of Mordor! You will swell their foul bellies with your putrefying flesh!
Red Arrow is one of Gondor's most treasured symbols, though few know just what it symbolizes. When our need is dire, we can present the arrow to the men of Rohan, and they are bound by ancient pact to ride to our aid. We should have used it in the early days of the siege, but the orcs encircled us so quickly, and Rohan is too far away.
I wonder whether Rohan would honor this arrow if they saw it.
Every time you run, man filth, you leave the stench of fear around you. Makes you easy to find.
Orcs are obsessed with rings, more so than coins or jewelry of equal value. They snatch them from prisoners immediately, and what happens to these rings is anyone's guess. We rarely find orcs actually wearing them.
A fine ring, but I gather it's an ordinary one.
Ha! Scarcely worth the same name as the ring we created.
Each city in Gondor administers its own justice in all but the most important cases. And in my lifetime, we've always handled legal matters in Minas Ithil. When I was a girl, I recall my father being much occupied with mercantile disputes and other legal affairs. Then the orcs came, and matters of justice yielded to matters of survival.
The Gaveler. Always seemed an odd symbol for justice.
What is justice, if not a hammer to beat down the proud nail? Gubu.
Don't get sick.
So brash, so sure of himself. Youth is wasted on the likes of you. But you won't live long enough to see the folly of your ways!
Shots!
Let's finish!
Gave me this scar, but you'll find it difficult to fire another without any hands.
I'll show you real combat!
filthy talk!
What was that noise?
Now you are!
Wait!
Gondor has faced the Witch King before, and he's had a vendetta against Minas Ithil ever since. This coin depicts the victor, Aenna, last king of Gondor. Generations ago, Aenna led an army that routed the Witch King and sent his army fleeing to Angmar. But our victory turned hollow when our king grew prideful. The Witch King challenged Aenna to single combat, and Aenna rode eastward from Minas Tirith, never to be seen again. It takes a nation to defeat such evil, not just one man.
Erenu, he who fought the Witch King.
Twice, because he did not finish the task the first time.
Keep him off balance! Feel this!
Should never leave an Uruk alive.
The ring is flawed. It was a mistake. We shook all of Mordor. We brought about the siege.
My ring is perfect. Its power is what shook Mordor. And that power will be ours again.
Kill you! Game of it!
The elves have mundane objects as we do, for even their common containers and vessels seem uncommonly fine. This artifact was once part of a table setting given as a gift centuries ago. The other parts were broken when one of Mordor's many ground tremors knocked them off a shelf. How I wish my predecessors had saved the broken shards. That's a puzzle I'd like to reassemble. Elven things deserve to last.
What sort of feasts do the elves have?
Stately affairs, not as raucous as orcs or men. Skark.
Again, you filth!
Bring it, I can't afford to it all! Fight on our way!
Die!
Gondorians called Minas Ithil home, but we cannot claim to have built it. That honor belongs to exiles from the fabled realm of Numenor beyond the Sundering Seas. Wondrous architects, they fashioned this city of marble to reflect the moonlight and glow with an inner warmth. But the city's beauty and light drew the ire of the Witch King, who has long sought revenge on Gondor.
The Numenorians' knack for towers rivals the elves.
Who do you think taught them? They were but precocious students.